Hello friends, today we will see one more sequential searching algorithm. So at the end of this session, students will be able to find out all the text positions where the pattern occurs using BDM algorithm. So what is BDM algorithm? It is backward DAWG matching algorithm or deterministic acyclic word graph algorithm. Now the word backward means we are processing from right to left in window position. We have already seen it in BDM algorithm also. Now this algorithm is based on suffix automata. So what is suffix automata? Automata which accepts all the suffixes of the given pattern or a string. Now consider the example here. The string is ABABA. Now there are 5 characters, so we are getting 5 suffixes. A string itself is a suffix, longest suffix. Then we are having this, so ABABA is a suffix. Then BABA, ABA, BA and A. So we are getting here 5 suffixes. So we need to find the automata which will accept all the suffixes. So how one can start? One can find non-deterministic automata for the given pattern. Convert that non-deterministic automata to deterministic one. Now in this automata, each path from initial node to any other internal node will represent a substring. Whereas path from initial node to any accepting node will represent one of the suffixes for the given pattern. So let us see with example. So again consider the same pattern ABABA. So this is the automata which accepts all the suffixes of this pattern. So if you look at this particular node A1 to 2 or the path from 1 to 2, it accepts A, so this is one of the suffix. Second is BA, so we have to start with 1, 3, 2 which is accepting BA. Third one is ABA, so we will be starting with 1, 2, 4, 5 which is accepting ABA, then BABA, so again 1, 3, 2, 4, 5 and the last is going to be ABABA. So in this way, we are reaching to one of the accepting state and we are finding the suffix. Now consider the path 1, 2, 4. Now 4 is an internal which is not an accepting state, so AB is a substring of a given suffix. So this is what the suffix automata which accepts all the suffixes for the pattern ABABA. Now consider the other pattern CAA where there are 3 characters and 3 suffixes CAA, AA and A. So at this moment, pause the video and try to find out the suffix automata which will accept suffixes of this given pattern. So you can directly draw the automata since the string is short, or you can find out the non-deterministic automata and try to convert it into deterministic one. So here is an answer. So here 1, 2, 3, 4 will accept CAA as a suffix, 1, 5, 4 will accept AA and at the end 1, 5 will accept A. So this automata accepts all the suffixes of the pattern CAA. So once you have understood that how to draw a suffix automata, we can go for this BDM algorithm. Now in this BDM algorithm, we have to find the suffix automata for the reverse pattern. Remember that we are processing from right to left. So automata will be found for the reverse string of the pattern. So P raised to R is nothing but a reverse pattern. So algorithm, as we have already said, that algorithm will search backwards inside the text for the substring of the pattern using automata. Now whenever we will find an accepting state, that means we have found a suffix. So we have to remember that particular position where we have found a suffix. And in that way, we will store this lattice prefix that we have already recognized, because prefix will be for a pattern which is same as suffix for the reverse pattern. So when we can say that match is found? When the complete window is read. So there will be two cases. Either we have completed the, we have read the particular window, or we have reached to a state where there is no transition. So in either of the case, window is need to be shifted with the longest prefix which we have already stored. So let us see with example how the BDM algorithm works. So we have already taken the pattern AABBAAB and the reverse string is BAABBAA. So this is a non-deterministic automata or with null transition. At any stage we can reach with the null transition, we can accept the suffix for that particular string. So consider the string AABBAA which is a suffix. So we can start with I and then we can move from 1 to 7 accepting this suffix AABBAAA. So we have found first non-deterministic automata. Now we will be converting it into the deterministic one. So we have not gone through the complete process, but this is the resultant one, deterministic automata for the reverse pattern. Now how we will start? Of course, we will start with the first position in the text. But what we have already discussed is that it will be the, we are going to process the characters from right to left. So here, this window, which is written in blue color, represents the text window which we are processing. And this is the first character that we are going to process. So what will be the set? The current character is A, which is at the mth position. And what is M? Is nothing but the length of our pattern. So in this case, the length of the pattern is 7. So we have, again, we have not yet occurred any of the suffix for the window. So we have written M as a last as in 7, and the text position is also always at 1. Remember that though we are processing from right to left, the pattern will occur from this left to right only. Okay. So we are at this initial stage. So we'll be processing the character A. So after processing, we'll be reaching to the state number 2, 3, 6, 7. So once we have processed A, we have reached to this 2, 3, 6, 7. So character is present, or the transition is present. So just decrement the value and go to the next character. So J is 6. Now since this is accepting state, it means that A is going to be the suffix. So we are storing that position in as in last. So last will become now 6. So again process this character A. So for this transition, it will be moving to the state number 3, 7. So for this A, we have moved to the state number 3, 7, and now J has been decremented to 5. So current character will become now B. So again, after processing this, we have reached to the state number 4, and again the position is 4, where the current character is A. So from A, we need to process now the character A. So now for this state number 4, there is no transition for this state A. So while moving, we have already, here we have seen that 3-7 is also an accepting state, so last has been changed to 5. Okay, so here we have got there is no transition for the state number 4 for the input A. So in this case, we have to move this pattern. So where will move this? Now the last position that we have remembered is 5. It means that this BA is the longest suffix that we have already found. Okay, so if you look at this, it is going to be AAB that we already processed, because we are processing from right to left. So AA and B that we have already found. So what will be the next text position? It will be the text position plus the last occurrence that we have found. So the next text position will be 6. So we are moving this window to the right by this many positions. So now we are coming to this. So next 7 characters from this position will be processed. Okay, so this will be the new setup. Again, we have to start from the right. So this is the new window. So again, J will be at 7. Last occurrence will be at 7. Text position is 6. And the current character is going to be B. So at this moment, pause the video and try to find out the transition and see that, again, are we finding the pattern or not. So the first character is B. We have processed this B and we have reached to the state number 145, and then we have decremented this J by 1. Now since this is not an accepting state, the last position is not changed. Again, the next character we have processed is A and we have reached to the state number 26. Again, this is not an accepting state, so we have reached to the state number, we have not changed this last position. So process the next character, which is nothing but A, and we have reached to the state number 37, and now the next character is going to be B. So here the character is B that we are already processed, and we have reached to the state number 4 and just decremented the value of J. So in this manner, we have reached to the state number 5. Now in this process, when the 37 is an accepting state, when we have got it, the last value is changed to 5 because this is an accepting state. So after processing this, we have reached to the start of the window, and then for A, we have reached to the accepting state number 7. Also, we have reached to this start of the window, or we have completely read that window or the characters in the window. It means that we can say that pattern is found at the position of 6. So I hope you have understood the process. We have started with the text position 1. We have processed one character, one by one character. In that, whenever we have got the accepting state, we have stored that position as we have found the prefix for the pattern and suffix for the window. And we have completed till either we are finding the pattern or we have to make the transition. So worst case complexity of this BDM algorithm is O of ML, whereas average case complexity is O of N log M divided by M. Thank you.